Welcome to It Happened in Grand Prairie, Texas, as we bring you the history of our city and the people that have made history and the people that are making history even this very day. And we are very honored today with our history tape number 647 to bring to you the THEE Superintendent of Schools for the Grand Prairie ISD, Dr. Susan Simpson. Dr. Simpson, how glad we are to have you back for this, I believe, starting your fourth interview since we grabbed you very early in your career and welcomed you to Grand Prairie, Texas.
Thank you.
We're glad
you're
back.
I'm thrilled to be here.
Oh, yes. And of all of the magic things that have happened since you came on board, we're just so pleased to let you make this what we call our annual history report that you and I do together. And we have a lot of surprises coming up in this wonderful happening today. What is happening in the wonderful world of Grand Prairie ISD?
We are celebrating. the main thing we've done in the last week when we started school is to be sure and celebrate the accomplishments of our children.
Yes.
And when I came on the show, which has now been 3 years ago, this is my fourth year as superintendent of Grand Prairie, the board had put in place a plan to be a recognized district within 5 years. And our teachers and our principals and our students have made that happen in 3 years. So it's time to set a new goal.
Yes, and you were really determined because I'm so surprised that you even missed the five-year plan, because it would have taken me 5 or 10 years to even stir the stick to get things going there. And you have done wonders.
Well, some people might say that we've been stirring the stick pretty good.
Yeah.
But we're really, really proud of our kids, and we're celebrating the numbers, but we're also just celebrating that our students in Grand Prairie are in a position to make great accomplishments after high school, to come back to this community, to strengthen our local and state economy, mm-hmm. because they're better prepared to be a viable part of the workforce and be taxpaying citizens.
What does it take to become, and why is it so important to be a recognized district? Now, recognized schools are fine, but mm-hmm. the entire district, tell me what you had to do to become that.
A recognized district means that we take all of the students cumulatively, all 26,400 students cumulatively, and of those students who are tested, and all of them aren't tested because we test third grade up, of those students who are tested, recognized means that 80% of our students and 80% of our students in every student population, including economically disadvantaged, passed the tax test. It also means that we had an 85% high school completion rate. And that is not easy to get.
No, it is not. And you have convinced every teacher that's in the Grand Prairie ISD that that's the purpose for these boys and girls to become a recognized school. Then you know what they're getting from you all and from the teachers and from the even the parents. You're involving the parents more in all of this.
We know that that feeling successful is a part of being successful, and that when our students can graduate from a recognized district, when our teachers can come and say that they teach in a recognized school district, our parents can know that their children are in a recognized school district, there's a sense of pride and a sense of accomplishment that perpetuates more success and more accomplishment.
And you have added to the staff some of the most remarkable people to help you achieve this. As a matter of fact, it has been spectacular at the different ones you have chosen to place in special places that have really been outstanding.
We have absolutely brilliant leadership. Of course, Dr. Alexander has been with the district for years, and I lean on him so much.
He has that stability for
does.
The community. But what some of the others have come from afar.
They have. Julie Spears is our assistant superintendent for business, and she her face may not be out there so much associated with being a recognized district, but everything works together.
Yes.
And if the money is not right, if the leadership from the board is not right, then you can't reach recognized. Everything works together. Of course, Dr. Jimerson is a graduate of Grand Prairie High School, and he's our deputy superintendent. Ms. De La Cruz, another assistant superintendent.
Wonderful.
Fabulous woman.
She's a wonderful supreme.
She is a good supreme.
Yes, she is.
Not quite like Diana Ross,
no.
But she's a great supreme.
Wasn't she?
And the programs that she oversees, Ms. Ruthie, aren't always right out in front either, because they're support services, social work services, psychological services, special education. And she is also oversees the department that serves our homeless children. And those children come to us with a special set of roadblocks that we have to get them past in order to achieve academically. So all of those roles are very, very important in getting to the point that we can say we're a recognized district, and that the parents in this school district are putting their children in high-performing schools.
I know that I'm especially fond of the two high schools, not the new Dubinsky, but the old heads
the
that were in town, the traditional ones that were here. And they have come a long way, baby, also, both of
they
them,
have.
And the ROTCs in each one of those.
Mm-hmm.
You have made such important, I guess, I'd say a salute to each one of those schools, because the principals have changed at both. You've brought from the principalship at South into your administrative
right.
circle. And the one at Green Prairie High School, of which I am closely affiliated, has been remarkable. He is outstanding. And he's gone through the baptism of fire in many ways, and he has withstood all of this. How do you make your choices so perfectly to place them in those places that you know you can count on them to help you do the things that need to be done for boys and girls?
Some of that's luck. We look for campus leaders who have a high need to achieve. We look for campus leaders who are competitive and who want to win, and who understand that bringing success to students means holding them to very high standards and having very high expectations, not just, well, this is good enough, or these children come from a tough place, so this is the best they can do and we'll help them. But we want leaders who say, it doesn't matter the background of a child, it doesn't matter the economic status of a child, it doesn't matter if their parents were fortunate enough to be educated themselves or not, it doesn't matter what language they speak, all of our children are smart and capable and deserve to be held to very high standards, so that when they become adults, they'll be able to make a good living, they'll be able to make good choices, they'll be able to be happy, and they'll be able to figure out that it feels really good to do something for somebody else every now and then.
How many new campuses have you brought on board since you've been here?
New and...
that were in the works.
Repurposed.
Kind of. Yes.
Of course, Dubisky.
Yes.
The bond was already in place mm-hmm. when I got here, the yeah. 07 bond. So we opened up Dubisky.
And that is magnificent.
It is magnificent. And the purpose of Dubisky is to provide choice for students and their families and their parents who want to focus on their career.
Yes.
And that might be a career such as the medical field, where they're going to go on for many years after high school, or it might be a career that offers them an opportunity to be ready to step into the work world after high school. Some of our, and we've talked about this before, some of our programs allow a student to step into the work world after high school as an avenue for them to fund college. For example, some of our cosmetology students will graduate from high school with a license as a cosmetologist or as a nail tech, but they want to use that skill to earn a living and put themselves through business college or go ahead and get a bachelor's degree. So Dubisky is a little bit different in that we want the students who come there to choose to come there because they're focused only on their education and where they want to be upon graduation.
That's wonderful. But you did take a Winn-Dixie mm-hmm. and turn it into a magic place for others mm-hmm. that aren't scheduled yeah. anything near like the Dubinsky. Tell me about that wonderful place, because you really did hustle the building from the city, because they bowed 3 times to the east of you and gave you first choice at that. And look what it's become. The city could have never done what you've done.
Well, I begged for the building.
Yes, you
from
did.
The city. I called Mr. Hart and said, please let me have it instead. And he was gracious enough to let me have it.
Yes.
And I appreciate that, because we believe that it has served our community really nicely. Crosswinds is an accelerated high school,
mm-hmm.
and it runs in 3 shifts, a morning shift, an afternoon shift,
I
and an
cars
evening
there
shift.
All of the mm-hmm. time.
It's open late into the night,
yes.
and that's to accommodate our students, and especially our older students, because we draw ADA at Crosswinds up through age 26. So if you have not yet had your 26th birthday and you don't have a high school diploma and you want one, you can come to Crosswinds and you can work 40 hours a week and go to Crosswinds in the evening. Or you can go to Crosswinds in the morning if you're younger than 21, and then still be through at noon and go to work. So lots of our kids and students have families they have to support. Sometimes it's the family that they grew up with, mom and dad. Sometimes it's a family that they've had along the way. But the state gives us funding for students up through age 26. Beyond that, we charge a nominal tuition in order to accommodate our spaces.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll take, if you didn't have a high school diploma, we would take you and you could walk across the stage.
Oh, that would be yeah. so wonderful. Isn't that exciting? And I've been to the graduation mm-hmm. and that is just mm-hmm. an exhilarating experience to see them mm-hmm. come through the lines and all of the
yeah,
things that happen.
It's great. It's That's a great opportunity.
Well, of all the new schools that have come on board, those are my two favorites. And I thank you for all of those. But I'd like to know exactly what in the whole campus that you have in the Grand Prairie ISD, what do you think is the most unusual success that you've mm-hmm. had in any one campus?
Wow. Unusual success. There are so many successes.
Yes.
And when you say successes, I tend to think about children.
Yes.
I witnessed an amazing success a couple of days ago that reminds me why we do what we do.
Yes.
And everyone who's ever taught can relate to this. I was not a kindergarten teacher. I was a secondary teacher, a secondary
uh-huh. yeah.
English teacher,
oh, yeah.
a PE teacher. Mm-hmm. So I don't, I have so much respect for the people who are willing to spend all day with all those little ones.
Little darlings.
And a few days ago, I went to Rayburn Elementary School.
Yes.
And I walked into Ms. Brown's kindergarten class,
mm-hmm.
and there were probably 5,000 five-year-olds in there. That's what it looked like. There were about 20, but they were everywhere.
All busy.
And a little boy came up to me and told me his name, and he told me that he was afraid of his scissors. And the teacher said that he was working on that, but he had not been able to cut things out yet. And all the children were coloring and cutting and gluing,
yes.
except this little boy. So I said, would you like me to sit with you? And he invited me to sit by him. And he really struggled with his scissors. He couldn't get his hands in them right, and he chopped at the paper, and he worked and worked, and we talked, and we changed his hands and the scissors, and he got his little circle cut out, and it was raggedy.
Oh, yeah.
And he jumped up, and he jumped up and down, and he said, Miss Brown, Miss Brown, Miss Brown, I did it. And she came over, and she hugged him, and she told him what a good job he
yes.
did. And that brought tears to my eyes, because those are the successes that
yes.
we need.
Yes.
And those are the successes that happen down at that every day. Those are the miracles that happen with 4-year-olds and 5-year-olds and 6-year-olds. And the teacher's response to those miracles makes or breaks whether they love school the rest of their lives. And that, so we can, you know, I could talk to you about our student who came to us from Mexico not speaking English and ended up going to MIT.
Yes, MIT.
I can talk to you about our students who have gone to the military academies and have scholarships, but the best stories are those stories of those children who have that little light bulb moment of success themselves, and that's what makes our teachers heroes right there. So yes. we're very, very proud that we have 16 exemplary campuses, 16 recognized campuses, a recognized school district. We have a teacher who has won a national award as an economics teacher. We have students who have won national awards in cosmetology and national awards in Skills USA, almost all of our athletic teams last year went to the playoffs. Our baseball programs went deep into the playoffs. But the real success stories, the real magic that you talked about, happens in classrooms every day. And the teacher says, oh, great, that's wonderful, and hugs the child, and she moves on to perform the next miracle.
And you just can't tell all of those stories in a small interview that we have here. Mm-mm. And all of the things that have happened to boys and girls that, if they were documented, wouldn't it be a wonderful book?
It would be a great book.
Well, I don't know whether... How many elementary campuses do you have? 26?
We have 23 now. 23. We had 25, and we repurposed Houston Elementary as a staff development center.
Yes,
it's great. It was a very expensive building to function as an elementary school, and it was also in a very dangerous place.
Most dangerous, 161.
So now we're doing staff development, new teacher training. It's a fabulous center. We also repurposed Bonham as an early education center. And I was there yesterday, and our children are from ages 6 weeks to 4 years old. And the halls are painted like crayons, and it's amazing.
Yes.
And I was there yesterday and visited classrooms and saw some really special little children there. And so we have the Early Education Center and 23 other elementary schools. Now, one of those elementary schools, Crockett, has been repurposed this year as a fifth grade campus. And I hope that you will have that principal come on your show and tell you about Crockett, because we have fifth graders from five or six other campuses come there. The focus is math and science. One of our primary focuses is to encourage our girls to go into the math and science fields. So we have four classes that are gender specific.
Oh.
And research shows us that sometimes when girls and boys are mixed together at the fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth grade level, the girls are not as quick to become engaged in math and science classes mm-hmm. as the boys are. So Ms. Meyer on that campus has separated them. She also has some classes that are project-based learning classes, and that means that the students are taught the rigor, and then they come together as teams and plan and develop and produce a project where they actually use their learning instead of just listening and hearing about how the Pythagorean theorem works. They actually use it to build something, uh-huh. a bridge, or mm-hmm. solve some economic or environmental problem. So we're really, really excited about Crockett being having just fifth graders. It's a real special age.
Yeah.
Gives them an opportunity to transition between elementary and middle school.
Is that an unusual happening in the fifth grade in other schools?
I have been told it is.
Yes.
There are, it's fairly common to have a fifth and sixth grade campus.
Yes.
That is an intermediate school. Mm-hmm. There aren't very many just fifth grade campuses. And it was really, it's really a pilot program. If it works out well, we would like to see other fifth grade campuses. You've heard me talk about this before, Ms. Ruthie. I believe with all my heart that parents have an absolute right to make some choices about where their children go to school and how they study and what they study. But I also believe that Grand Prairie ISD can offer those choices better than anyone else.
Yeah.
We have certified, top-of-the-line master teachers. We have all the support necessary. We can provide parents better choices, better rigor, better academic opportunities than anyone else. A few of the fifth graders who are coming to Crockett are coming there by choice. Most of them are coming there because we created some pre-K through fourth grade schools to funnel all of our fifth graders there. I hope that this is so successful that our community wants other fifth grade campuses. For example, we might be able to open a fifth grade campus that is designed to focus on the arts. And then a parent could choose if they wanted their child to go to a traditional pre-K through five campus, or Crockett fifth grade where the focus is math, science, technology, or another fifth grade where the focus is fine arts.
Well, we're to the point where I'm not even going to get to ask you about the garden programs that we have, that Tammy Chan will be very disappointed that I didn't take time to do that, and the many other innovative things that you've done since last year when we talked. But my time is getting to the place where I need a surprise on this show. And I haven't asked you about your dad that we love and adore.
My dad's great.
I know your dad's great. He's feeling well.
He's feeling well.
Yes.
Yeah.
So with your permission, I'm going to let you rest for a moment. We'll be right back with a surprise on our show.
Honesty, pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Welcome back. We're very excited. We wanted a miracle to happen today. And the superintendent of schools can do miracles with kids and with teachers and facilities and all of this. And she made a big change in her life, which made a big change in our lives because she brought on board a new young man in her life. And we're so pleased that we have him with us today. Kent Hall, welcome to the set, young man.
It's wonderful to be here.
Yes. Well, it's wonderful to have you here and to recognize you as Mr. and Mrs. That is just a magnificent happening in our lifetime, and we're just so pleased that we were able to have you with us here today. And Your Majesty, isn't it wonderful to have him on the divan with you?
It's great.
So that all the people in Grand Prairie could know what a wonderful happening that was, and who gave you away at the wedding?
My son walked me down the aisle,
yes.
And then my dad stood up with us. And
your dad, that is one of the most famous principals in East Texas, and also superintendent of schools and everything else, and your mentor, and besides that, a lovely dad.
He's great.
He's in good health right now.
He's in good health.
All right. Brother Kent,
wonderful man.
Tell me a little bit about the real Kent Hall.
Oh, well, I don't know. Right now, I'm Susan Simpson Hall's husband is basically who I am now.
Well, Mr. Jackson feels the same way about things like that.
He does. I've met him at Rotary a time or two, and what a pleasure he is.
Yes.
Well, you know, I used to be Colton's dad. My son's Colton. He's 23. Yes. Yesterday was his birthday.
Oh.
And we went and had a good birthday party last night. But I'm Susan's husband. So.
Yes.
And
that
makes a difference. I'm very content to be such.
Yes, that is wonderful. You have expanded your territories in a marvelous, marvelous way.
I think
that's
so.
That's great.
As well.
What do you do for a living, if you do for a living?
Well, I have an oil company in Kilgore, Texas.
Yes, good.
And that I have somebody that runs that most of the time. And then I'm in the construction business, work some for the government during hurricane recovery and things of that nature.
That's wonderful. That is good.
And trying to make a really good husband for Susan.
I see. Are you looking to be a volunteer for the city of Grand Prairie in any way? We need to know about that. Just say it.
I've done a lot of that kind of stuff, you know. So now that I'm back in Grand Prairie quite a bit, I intend to do a lot of things. Susan has a real philanthropic heart, and so we're going to be doing some things.
Is there any magic to the meeting of this lady?
Magic? Oh, it was magic. It was very much magic.
Yeah. It was.
Absolutely. We knew like a day or two after we met that we were going to be together.
I see.
Didn't we?
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
It was.
And
did
this happen over a period of 5 days or 25 years or what?
It happened over a period of 2 days, I think.
2 days.
Yeah. 2 days or maybe a millennium.
And it, sure.
Yeah,
and it doesn't
sure.
take long to figure that out.
Mm-mm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it doesn't. When it's right, it's right. And we knew it was. So.
That is wonderful. And you're making your home here and there?
Well,
that's a good question. We have two homes.
That's good.
Kent is on the school board in Brock, Texas,
yes.
west of Weatherford.
Yes.
So he's required to live in the district.
Yes.
And of course, as the superintendent, my contract requires me to live in the district
yes.
here.
Uh-huh.
So as far as your show's concerned, we live here because my contract requires me to live here.
That's yeah. right.
We usually spend weekends out in Parker County.
Oh, and yeah. that's lovely, mm-hmm. lovely mm-hmm. country out there, isn't
yeah,
it?
I live on the same land that I was born on, so same kind of an area and small community and
well,
rural,
I usually ask
quiet.
This question. Would you name your parents?
Name my parents?
Yes.
My mom was Willie Jean Jones. And her last name, she married my dad, is Hall. My dad was Noel Emmett Hall.
That's wonderful.
And
that's great.
Susan's dad's middle name is Emmett.
Did you have brothers or sisters?
I have four sisters and two brothers.
That's wonderful.
My two brothers live in one in Sacramento, one in the Los Angeles area, and the other one, and my four sisters all live close.
Oh, that is great.
Yeah.
That's wonderful.
Yeah, we have a wonderful
Is there anything
family.
You'd like to add about this young man before we cause this place to go to thunder in a little bit?
Well, I don't want to tell any secrets.
Okay. So. Well, you don't have to tell any secrets, but you could brag on him just a little bit.
Well, he's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
And has been very willing to accompany me to all the events that I go to, and that's been really, really nice. I've been, I have been a single parent for 15 years.
Yes.
So it's been so easy to make this change in my life, and it's been so nice to have someone willing to go with me and support me and in my job and all the other things that go with it and with my kids. And we're just having a blast.
Well, there are three people, at least three people, and maybe the fourth one with your dad, that had to give approval when you made up your mind to make all of these
changes.
Oh,
it was much more than that. There were many.
Oh, there were many that had to give approval.
There were many. And a lot of them right here in GPISD.
Oh, I see. Were they tolerant?
I think, they finally let me have her, finally.
Yes. Yes. And the wedding was where?
The wedding was in Cleburne.
In Cleburne?
And my almost sister's house, Rhonda and Ray Crest. It was outside yes. next to Little Lake. It was we started off as just planning a really small wedding, and we didn't have more than 200 people there, right?
Right.
We had a great time, a great party, and it was fabulous. We have great pictures that we're going to print someday. Mm-hmm. When
and
we're
going to live happily ever after.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Yes. I knew that both of you all would be in agreement to that. I want to congratulate you publicly on this television show because I thought it was nice for everyone to know how wonderful happiness is when it's for real.
It's a great thing.
It's for real.
Yes, it really is. And even though he has to bow three times to the east to the superintendent of schools in Grand Prairie, Texas.
He doesn't have to bow.
On a regular basis.
On a regular basis.
You're
very
accomplished.
Often. Well, I want to thank y'all both for allowing us to get into your personal life. But we have congratulations forever for you two. And we have
you
on our prayer list because we know that you don't need the prayer, but
you're
accepting that. You're accepting that readily. Thank you all so much
Thank
for
you,
being
Ruthie.
Here. Thank
Enjoyed
you for,
it as
for
always.
Your majestic role as the superintendent and as the new wife of Brother Kent.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Ruthie.
Thank you. Y'all are wonderful.
To know
and
you.
And this is Ruthie Jackson reminding you that history is as we live and do, and that we document it as correctly as we possibly can. And thank you for allowing us to be with you today. Thank you for being always helpful to Grand Prairie, Texas, and being volunteers and helping our city to grow in a majestic way, as Dr. Simpson has, by adding just one to a wonderful happening. Thank you all for being here. God bless you.